Samir is a city planner. He is responsible for helping to improve public transportation in the growing municipality of Greendale. One day, a report lands on his desk. It reads, 80% of the city's residents are satisfied with the current public transportation system. That's great news, right? But what if Samir was able to tap into resources that allow him to read beyond that headline? Through his knowledge and understanding of how to access the data that the report was based on, Samir is able to break down or disaggregate the data further. He discovers that only 60% in the city's northern district are satisfied, and they're often complaining about irregular bus services. The central district, where many office workers live, has an oversaturation of buses during off-peak hours, but a shortage during rush hours. The newer southern district, with its recent infrastructure developments, enjoy a 95% satisfaction rate. Senior citizens, who represent a sizable percentage of the city's population, report a satisfaction rate of only 50%. Noting a lack of accessible options for those with mobility issues. If Samir acted solely on the initial 80% satisfaction data, he might conclude that the public transportation system only needs minor tweaks, meaning he would be contributing to the continuation of underserved and dissatisfied demographics, not to mention the wasting of resources by having too many buses during off-peak times. But by breaking down or disaggregating the satisfaction data by geography and age groups, he is able to reassess and increase the frequency of buses in the northern district, adjust bus schedules in the central district to align better with the office rush hours, and create a new program to enhance accessibility for senior citizens. For Samir, the importance of knowing how and where to access disaggregated data to help understand the diverse needs of different communities and areas play an integral part in his ability to make decisions that ensure every resident gets the quality of the service they deserve. Similarly, it can be very effective for all levels of governments and organizations that serve communities to use disaggregated data to make evidence-informed public policy decisions. By using disaggregated data, policymakers are able to design more appropriate and effective policies that meet the needs of each diverse and unique Canadian. As much as possible, the data should be disaggregated by gender, age, ethnocultural identity, Indigenous identity, different geographies, and any other community-relevant identity factors, and presented distinctly for each specific subgroup.